Hi guys, I'm Mike from Roland and I am the UK drum product specialist. And I'm here today at GUITARGUITAR to show you the new TD-27KV. So the TD-27KV comes with three PDX-100 pads for your toms, VH-10 hi-hats, CY-12C and a CY-13R as your crash cymbals, and also the digital pads from the TD-50, which you may be familiar with. So the beauty of having the digital pads on the TD-27 module is for expression. You have a 14-inch snare pad that comes complete with the anti-static technology that it comes with on the 50. The beauty of having the PD-140DS with the TD-27 module and the anti-static technology is it feels more real and it reacts like a traditional snare drum would, sorry. So the anti-static technology works like it does with your iPhone, your Android phone. It picks up the static in your hand and plays the sound according to that. So this on the snare drum works like this. So there you can hear a normal rim sound, and when I move my hand closer, the snare drum picks up the anti-static or the static in my hand and then changes the tone and the sound to a traditional click. The way it works with the ride cymbal is very similar, except rather than change sound, it just simply mutes the sound like it would on my crash cymbals when I clench the edge. So let's take a listen to some of the sounds and some of the preset kits in the TD-27. I'll start off with kit number two, which is Studio A. On the TD-27 module, similar to that of the TM6 Pro and the TD-50, you can also have mute groups. So in this example, I've got kick versus snare, which is a preset on the TD-27, and the mute group is set up between the kick and the snare. So just a quick explanation into what a mute group is. It's where two sounds will not play together. So the kick drum sounds like this, and the snare drum sounds like this. So as you can hear from the kick, you've got the elongated sample, which will be cut whenever I play the snare. And that is what a mute group, or what you can set up in the TD-27, which is a mute group. So this is what kit number 22, kick versus snare, sounds like. So another thing about the mute groups is it doesn't have to be between your kick and snare drum. It can be across any pad, even the auxiliary pads. So just a quick recap what a mute group is. Two sounds will not play at the same time. So for example, I'll just play on the crashes as well, where the mute group is assigned to the snare. So the elongated sound of the crash will not play over the snare sound. So now if we take a more in-depth look at the TD-27 module. So on the module, you can edit things like the actual sound of the instrument itself. So for example, if I didn't want my snare drum to sound like a snare drum, I could set it so that it sounds like a bass drum. I could set it to be another tom. I can set it to wherever I want. If I can hear it, I can set it to that particular sound. As well as this, I can change the tuning of the snare drum or any of the other pads. The way it works with the cymbals is I would be changing the size. As well as tuning, you've got muffling, which simply adds tape or earrings to the drums. So I'll show you a quick example of how you can deaden your snare drum using the muffling feature. As I hope you can hear there, as we went on and as I was turning the knob more and more to the right and more muffling was added, the deader or the less resonance was coming from the sound of the drum. Similar to the TD-17 and TD-50, the TD-27 comes with user sample import as well. With this feature, you have also at your disposal the three different layer types. So you have mix, which is where the two samples will play together at the same velocity. You have fade, which comes with three different fade points, which simply means that when you hit over a certain velocity, your sample or your second sample will gradually come in. Lastly, we have switch. So switch is exactly what it says on the tin. It's either your layered sample or your main instrument. So for example, if I layered my snare drum sound right now with a clap sound and I had the switch setting on, as soon as I reached a certain velocity, my clap sound would only be able to be heard. Another great feature of the TD-27 module is the direct outputs. This is great for live use, especially when you have studio or sound engineers who require to take your individual kick and snare drum outputs so they can mix separately. It's very simple to assign and very easy to customize the kit so that particular pads are sent out via the direct outs. So also in the TD-27 module, we have something new, which is called PureAcoustic Ambience Technology. This simply means that you change the sound of the room that you're in or that you want to be in. So for example, if I want to be in sound like I'm in a small studio, then I can set the settings in the module to sound like that. If I want to sound like I'm in a hall, then I can also change that. So here are a few examples of me flipping through the different room sounds on the TD-27. All I'm doing now is I press kit edit, which brings me to this nice chain of effects, which you can see what you're affecting and what affects what. So if we go to the room there and press enter, at the minute you can see that we're in a small studio. So this is what, and if we change the level to the maximum it can be, this gives you the best idea possible of the power of the module and the power of this PureAcoustic Ambience technology. So this is kit number 40, Indie Rock. We're in a small studio. So now, rather than being in a small studio, I'm going to put us in, let's have a look, middle hall number 4. And again, the level is set to plus 6, which is the maximum it can be. And let's just maximize all the settings there so we can really hear the difference. So also on the TD-27KV, you have additional three auxiliary inputs, and these can be for any pads. So similarly to what you can do now, you can assign them to be any sound you want. You can have a second snare, you can have another tom, and another crash cymbal if you wish, or you can have all crash cymbals. It's totally up to you. Another option for connectivity you have on the TD-27 module is USB app. This allows you to connect to any DAW and stream audio and MIDI data, or even one or the other. So also on the TD-27 module, you can play along to songs via an SD card or via Bluetooth. When you use the SD card function and when you have the SD card in, you can record direct to this SD card with or without the backing track. There are also a couple of songs built into the TD-27 module, so I'll play along to an example for you now. Thank you. So in summary, if you want a kit with Bluetooth connectivity, sample import, sample layering, digital pads with enhanced expression, great sounds, external connectivity as well for your DAW, the TD-27KV is the kit for you. I've been Mike. Thanks to GUITARGUITAR for having me today, and hope you enjoy.